Good afternoon to all of you. We are here today to, as the first of our doorstep astronomy sessions, we are going to do a discussion. In this very first session of doorstep astronomy, we are going to have discussions about the many facets of the moon, or we may even call many faces of the moon. Yes. So, yes. So now we are ready to get started in our doorstep astronomy session on the moon, many facets of the moon. And the way we are planning this as a kind of a video magazine, which is going to go online every Monday about the same time, and you're all welcome to come and participate with us on this YouTube link. And the chat for this YouTube link, I want that we use it very effectively to take your inputs. What is it that you are thinking about this session? What do you want to know about the topic we are discussing? What are your questions and any feedback, anything that you want to tell us? We want this particular topic to be covered in the coming weeks and so on. So let us use the chat effectively for that. If we use the chat for general messages, hello and so on, what happens is that it becomes a little confusing for us to know the relevant messages. So let us stick to using the chat from once the session starts. We'll use the chat to ask your questions and also any other inputs that we may want to give as well. So now let us get started with our moon session. And we are going to be here for about maybe an hour or an hour and a half. And I'm hoping that some of you will come into our studio while we are doing this session. So how will you do that? Based on your questions, which we can see here. So based on your questions, if I find that there is some question which is very useful for interaction, what we are going to do is just mention, say that such and such question is good. Ask you to send a mail to nehruplanetarium@gmail.com. Let me just give that link, nehruplanetarium@gmail.com. I have not put that. So nehruplanetarium@gmail.com. If you send a mail with your question, so don't just send any mail right now, just send email. Don't do that. Send a mail, your question also has to be there. And we will reply to you and give you the link to enter this discussion studio. So you can be here with us in this discussion studio and put your questions and your thoughts and so on. And then, of course, make way for others as we go along. So this is the very first one, first of the sessions that we are having today. So it may take a little while for us to get into the logistics working for this. And today's session is going to be about the moon. And there are such rich facets of the moon. Once we actually get going, trying to understand what moon is all about and what is it that we can see. So today's session, at least to begin with, we are just going to concentrate on getting to know, getting to view the moon and getting to know some of its features. Now, why is that? Well, on its own, the features of the moon, we can see moon right now behind me. The various features of the moon. Today we are going to concentrate on two particular aspects of it, what are called the maria, the dark regions on the moon, and the craters. So the maria are oceans on the moon. People initially thought there were some oceans, but now we know that these are very large impact basins which have been filled over with flow of lava from early evolution of the moon. And so that is what these dark patches that we see. And then we see those craters. So what are these two? And first, let us just try and make friends with a few of them. All right. So let me put a labeled image which shows some of the features of the moon, which are the maria, the oceans, so-called oceans on the moon, which are the lava plains. And now, I will ask you all to pay a little attention, and maybe you all know some of these features. The reason why I want you to be able to remember some of these features, because if you want to do certain observations, in particular, we are going to do I'm going to suggest that we do observations in connection with a phenomenon called libration. You all must have heard that the moon shows us, okay, think that this is the moon, that moon shows us always the same face. That's what you have perhaps read in your textbooks and so on. Well, the actual situation is a little richer than that. And firstly, why is it that it shows us the same face? That also we'll discuss a little later. But firstly, we just want to check. That is the task for us right now. The first task in this magazine which we are going to do is when somebody tells us that you're going to see the same face of the moon all the time, we want to check, this is the face that you see behind me. So do you see that all the time or not? So to know that, what is it that we want to do? We want to be able to identify features on the surface of the moon. So there are two features which we are concentrating on. There are many others, but we'll come to that maybe in later discussions. So the dark patches, these are lava plains, and on these lava plains, actually, the material which is here reflects less of sunlight. So you know that moon is just sending us reflected sunlight, right? So we have all the, see, this is Mare Serenitatis here, Mare Tranquillitatis. So Sea of Serenity, Sea of Tranquility. This is the Sea of Vapors, Mare Vaporium. And here, this is useful for some of the observations that we want to do. This small standalone feature, this is Mare Crisium, and we have Mare Fecunditatis, Nectaris, and Mare Humorum, Mare Nubium, and we have also the region called Oceanus Procellarum. It's a huge region here, and so on. We have also the Mare Frigoris here. So these are some of the regions which people name as oceans. We know they are lava plains. Now, there is going to be a quiz for us in a little while. So, is it possible for you just to try, when I point out to a particular feature, will you be able to remember which it is? And here, okay, we have also the Mare Imbrium, a largish region here. If you look at it through a pair of binoculars, you can see a ray of light passing through that. A ray of brighter material on the surface of the moon. So, we have the Sea of Serenity, Sea of Tranquility. This is the first moon landing region. Sea of Vapors here. Mare Crisium here, and Humorum, Nubium, Oceanus Procellarum, Frigoris, and we have Mare Fecunditatis and Mare Nectaris here. So please, is it possible that you try and remember at least some of these features? We are going to have a small quiz very soon. And let's now go to the craters. And we may just have very few of them labeled. There are just hundreds of craters on the moon. And if you have a lot of interest, perhaps in some time, you may actually get to know them. I'm going to also tell you how you will be able to get to know a lot about features on the surface features on the moon. And now, I'm just checking whether there are any questions. I still see that there are many general messages. Please refrain from general messages, because I'm just trying to see if there are any useful questions, and I'm not able to see because of all these general messages. Please refrain from general messages, and if you have any questions, you're very welcome. Please put them in the chat, and we will discuss them as we go along. So now we are trying to identify some of the main craters. We have just very few craters which are put here. There is a trio of three craters here: Copernicus, Kepler, Aristarchus. This trio, there is of course the big crater Tycho. This is the most well-known feature on the surface of the moon, crater-wise. And we have a few other craters, Pythagoras, Pascal. We will see. In a while, we will see those craters. And we also have, of course, the craters Langrenus and Stebbins. These craters are there. So don't worry about those less-known ones. But at least Tycho, Copernicus, Kepler, Aristarchus. Could you see? Copernicus, Kepler, Aristarchus, and Tycho. Yeah. So there is a question saying what are craters. So in fact, to understand what craters are, we are just going to go and make a crater ourselves. But see, moon has a large number of craters. You can see behind me on the picture, some of the craters are mentioned. In a while, we'll go and look at very deep pictures of the moon. So many craters can be seen then. Now, what are these? craters happen when, you know, any debris material which is there in the solar system, when the solar system was forming, it was a huge cloud of gas and dust, and clumps became the planets and the satellites and so on. And leftover material is still there, perhaps some of it. And sometimes it is caught by the gravity of the moon or gravity of the earth or Jupiter, and it plunges onto the surface of these objects. And it makes these impact craters. And what happens is that sometimes in this impact crater, when it, the surface features like the lava plains perhaps, they're not very reflective. But inside material may be more reflective. The reflective material gets thrown out and makes those bright lines, rays of light that you see here. That is the more reflective material which has been thrown out. So to do this, let's do one thing. To have an idea about this, we are just going to make a small crater ourselves. So Prerna, I am going to call you in. Our team from the planetarium is waiting for us. And we have Prerna, Rajesh, Balchinder, Sanjay, Manish, they are all standing there. We are going to go, this is, you are in the planetarium now. And Prerna and Balchinder are standing there. You can see where we have the crescent moon. Some of you may have come to the planetarium before. So Prerna, what I am going to do is hand over to you. Walk our viewers through the activity that we are going to do to get a feel for craters on the moon. Go ahead, Prerna.
Yeah. Hi. Good evening to everyone. I, Prerna, welcome you all to the Planetarium online session. So, as ma'am told, today we are here to discuss about the moon. So, we have a small demonstration, a DIY activity planned for you. You can make your crater at home. So, what is crater? Before making a DIY,
the sound is not coming very clear. So, you repeat, and if the problem persists, I will explain what is happening there. Go ahead.
All right. I think there is a small glitch in the video.
No, so the problem is.
At the Planetarium online session. Today we are here to know more about the crater and a small activity is all lined up for you.
Prerna, the problem is persisting. So you go ahead. We are going to do the demonstration of the crater making activity, right? And in that we have the tub over there. Can you just show the tub which is kept there? The tub in which we have kept some material. The material is at the bottom of the tub. We have coarse material, maybe Badarpur sand or something. On the second most layer, we have very thin, fine powder, maybe maida we use sometimes, maida, rangoli powder, very fine. Maida seems to be working best. And on top of it, we need coal powder. I think right now we are still using rangoli powder. And Balchinder, for the viewers, can you make one crater on this, our surface of the moon? So, can you show the, 1 minute, can you show the pebble also, a little close up of the pebble? We take a pebble which is kind of not too rounded. Yeah. So, then you make a couple of craters now for our viewers. And yeah, so that's an impact crater which is formed on the surface of the moon there. And all of you can do this activity on your own. It's great fun. You just need the fine black powder and the fine white powder. The white powder is the second last layer. And can we now take a look at a little close-up of the crater itself? So you can see that the more reflective material has come out. Sometimes the rays are formed here, as Balchandra is showing us. So this is an activity which gives us an idea about craters which are formed. So now, all right. So I think for now, thank you, Prerna and Balchandra, for giving us a view of that. Let's keep it ready in case there are questions. We can repeat this activity in a while. All right. So now, So as far as the questions are concerned, there was somebody who wanted to know what are craters. I think we already had a discussion of that. Somebody wants to know which is the largest crater on the moon. Anjali Singh, could you send a mail to nehruplanetarium@gmail.com, and perhaps you could come into the studio in a while. And let's see, what are the other questions? What is the top and bottom of the moon? All right, okay, that's an interesting question. Okay, there is a question here. Moon is too cold. All right. This is a very useful question. Moon is too cold. Sun rays come to the moon and ice will melt. So there will also be water on the moon. All right. So that's an interesting question. So Mimi, could you also send a mail to nehruplanetarium@gmail.com so we could call you into the studio and we'll take this question up as we go along. All right. We'll take this question. Please remember, if I don't, then put this in the chat also, that we want to take up this question about presence of water on the moon. We all know that there isn't much. For a long time, it was thought that moon has no water at all. And more recently, and the Chandrayaan mission has played a very crucial role in this, some amount of water presence as hydroxyls have been found on the surface of the moon. And I'll show you a view also of that in a little while when we'll come back to the discussion about the presence of water on the moon and the sun melting this and making water and so on. We will discuss some of these aspects. All right. So, but first let's continue with what we wanted to do, which is we wanted to make friends with the features on the moon. So I hope you all had a view. The question which was about the largest crater, that is Tycho. Tycho, you can see Tycho behind me here, right? That is the largest crater on the moon. And so I hope you'll remember at least some of the craters. So we had a look at Kepler, Copernicus, Aristarchus, right? And also Grimaldi. That's another crater that you need to be aware of. There's a kind of a small plop from Oceanus Procellarum region, which is crater Grimaldi. And so that's one there. That's Grimaldi. So you need to have an idea about what these are. And also Crisium, right? We had a look at Mare Crisium. So please keep in mind and which are these regions. We are going to have a little bit of a quiz in a while. So now these are the regions, surface regions on the moon. And I'm going to help you now figure out how you will find out more of these regions. And why? Because if you want to know about the process of what is called libration. So we were talking about how maybe in that your textbook you have read that the moon is always showing you the same face. And why is it showing the same face? Take a look at that also. And then why is it not really showing always the very same face? Which means if it were going to show you the same face all the time, you should be seeing only 50% of the moon. But instead what you are going to see is about 59% of the moon. So why is that? And I want you not just to know that you can see 59% of the moon, but the whole point of today's session is for you to be able to actually observe and make out for yourself that yes, I am seeing small differences in the face of the moon. So that is what we are planning to do. And for that you need to know some of the features. You need to know how you can find out more features on the surface of the moon. I will do that in a while. And you also need to be able to do a little bit of a sketch of the moon. So we are going to now also go and take a look at how we are going to sketch the moon. And I hope now, Prerna, from that side, the noise aspects have been solved. So we are going to go back again where our planetarium staff are. So I'm going to call now Rajesh, our planetarium artist, and he is going to show you some sketching. So Rajesh, can I call you in? Rajesh? Yes. So can we take a look at the work which is being done there? You're going to help people. Can I just test whether the sound from there is coming all right? Rajesh, I'll hand over to you. Yes. Rajesh, can you tell the viewers?
मैं आपको क्रेटर्स मून के क्रेटर्स बनाना सिखाऊंगा जैसे हम
राजेश द साउंड प्रॉब्लम इज स्टिल कंटिन्यूइंग साउंड प्रॉब्लम इज कंटिन्यूइंग सो लेट मी ट्राई एंड फिल इन फॉर यू यू प्लीज डेमोंस्ट्रेट सो राजेश इज शोइंग अस दिस लार्ज शीट ऑफ पेपर राजेश गो अहेड एंड डू द डेमोंस्ट्रेशन ऑफ How you are doing the sketching? So,
yes,
Yes. So, Yes. So he has actually he has marked out a few major features. Some of the major features that you can see in pencil, very light. And so those of you who may have artistic inclinations, of course, may want to do a very good job. But when we are doing it for the sake of our observations, you just need to be aware of the major features, and your drawings have to be recognizable. So he's drawing them with pencil initially, and then he's going to fill in paint and so on. And as you can see, he has done some of these. Look at these features here. So where you have the Serenicatus, Tranquillitatis, Nectaris and Picantitatis, this looks to me, for instance, like what is it? Like a menduck, frog, face of the frog, body of the frog, legs of the frog, and so on. So, and then you have this huge Oceanus Procellarum there, and some of the features. So you just have to have an idea, as Rajesh is demonstrating to you. Initially, just put the major features that you can see. Point out the by pencil you can draw, and then you can use paint, or you can just use pencil sketch if you like. But you have to be able to sketch and show, be able to, for yourself, be able to recognize that this is the face of the moon. So you need to know the features on the moon, and you need to be able to sketch them, even if they're rough sketches. And but Rajesh will show you after some time his some of his work where you have beautiful views of the surface of the moon, and you can choose what you like to do. But you have to have some bare minimum sketching, unless of course you have astrophotography skills. If you have astrophotography skills, there's nothing like it. So if you are able to take some amount of optics, some aperture of optics, a telescope or a binoculars, have a camera behind that, and so there are a lot of learning issues involved in this. But otherwise, if you are able to manage that, and let's see if the sound is, yeah, Rajesh, let's see if the sound disturbance is removed, and let's see if we can hear you give the advice to students. All right, there seems to be some issue also with the network connectivity there, but that was a demonstration, and I'm going to show the demonstration a little later from my presentation also. So how to do these sketches, and so these are the two aspects that we talked about. And then, yeah, we can still see there is some more of the work which is going on for the sketching. So let's keep that in the background. And then, what is behind all of this? What is behind all of this? Why are we doing all of this? Firstly, perhaps you have some idea about the phases of the moon. Let's just take a look at moon, what you can see of the moon. And so I'm going to put my presentation here, and all right, we have one of the viewers who has come in. So, but first let me show you some of the phases of the moon. You are all familiar with these phases. And now why is it that we are having the phases? Let me just give a very quick description of it. You have to have the idea of phases in the background when you are looking at libration, because you will not be seeing the full moon all the time. So you, if you have from where you are seeing the sun, wherever the sun is, the moon is in the opposite direction. All the light from the sun is going and falling on the moon and coming back to you. You will see that, you can see here from each of these animations, the white part is where the sunlight is falling and the black part is where the sunlight is not there. And so you can see that here there's only this part which we are seeing out of that. We see a crescent. Here half of it we see lit, half of it not. A little more of it lit, not. Here all the sunlight coming, falling here, exactly coming back to you. We see the full moon. We see the gibbous moon and so on. So this is the reason why we have phases. We are going to do several more activities about phases. So you'll get a better idea of why is it that we are having phases. Now, after that, we want to have a look at, all right, this is a little bit more about phases. So let me move that, and I wanted to come to, once again, the features of the moon and a little bit about Okay. Why is it? Yeah, only just this one part. Let's take a look at why is it that we are seeing the same face of the moon towards us all the time. So the moon is moving around the earth and it is spinning as well as rotating at the same speed. You are perhaps all aware of it. And that results in the fact that, see, look at this arrow here. If the arrow comes back here, it has finished one spin. And if the moon comes back here, it has finished one rotation. So you can see that the moon is in the same time, it has done one spin and one rotation. And that is the point which is talked about, that the fact that moon is spinning and going around the earth at the same speed is what is going to make sure that we see the same face of the moon all the time. But there are some other aspects added to it which causes this libration. But before that, maybe what we are going to do is, firstly, we have one of our viewers who has come into the Ahana. And can you unmute your mic and tell us what your question is?
Mom, why don't we have craters on the moon, on the earth?
Yeah, that's a very, very good question. If you like, you can put your video on, but your audio is there. That's very good. So, Ahana Gupta had this question. Why is it that we see so many craters on the moon, but not so many on the earth? We don't see so many craters on the earth. That's a very good question. And the answer to that is that earth is a very dynamic system. Earth is a very dynamic system. So we have so much of geological activity going on. So we have the atmosphere, we have all the thunders and all that, we have the life, we have the plants, and we also have volcanic activity and so on. Moon no longer has that. So what happens is that on the moon, over a period of time, these do not get wiped out. They do not get wiped out. Unlike on Earth, they get wiped out. These geological features, they get wiped out. So we see that. Ahana, thank you. When you wish, you could leave the studio also, unless you have another question, because the studio can take only a few people. So if you are finished with your question, you can click on the leave studio button. Thank you, Ahana. That was very good. We have another viewer, Dhruv. So can you tell us what is your question, please? Unmute your mic and tell us what your question is.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, my question is.
There is a lot of disturbance. Yes, go ahead. Yes, please go ahead. We cannot hear your question. Okay.
Ma'am, my question is, I was in astronomy club. Ma'am, when I was in astronomy club, so they told me.
Please go on. You have not told your question as yet. You have repeated several times, but not the question.
Ma'am.
All right.
Ma'am, when I was in astronomy club, at the distance of my
Okay, Dhruv, there is a lot of disturbance. Could you just put your question in chat? There's a lot of audio disturbance from your side. Put your question in chat. And so there is, yes, somebody is sending mail, but if with a question, if you send, you'll get a response. Okay, is the distance between Earth and Moon increasing or decreasing? Sachin, you can come in by sending a mail. Ajay Dashur, do the moons in other planets have, okay, that's an interesting question here. Do the moons in other planets have the same craters? Do the other moons have craters at all? Are they duplicates of our moon? Well, each crater is one object, one small, maybe a kilometer size or smaller object which has fallen on the moon. So each crater is going to be individual. So almost all solar system objects will have craters. Earth also has craters, does have craters, but very few because they have been washed out. So, okay, what is the duration of night and day in moon? So Jerome, you can also come into the studio by sending a mail. Okay, there was a question, I think Piyush Kumar Sharma, whatever your question, unmute your mic and you can tell your question, please. Go ahead with your question. Go ahead with your question, please.
Yes, ma'am. Piyush, ma'am, I have more than one question. It is that why the moon means does the sun revolve around the Milky Way galaxy? And ma'am, more than that, I have a question that what will happen if the mass of the moon be the same as that of the Earth?
If they happen to be the same. Okay, so you go to the Pluto-Charon system. Pluto and Charon system, they are roughly same mass. Pluto, and we think of Charon as a moon of Pluto. So they actually revolve around a common center of mass, which is closer to the center point between them. Okay, so you can actually discern the movement of both easily. Here in Earth and Moon, the common center of mass is much closer to the Earth. So there is that. And all right, there is a lot of disturbance. Piyush, your first question, actually, I was not very clear. Just wait a minute, please. Okay. So what is your question, Lavish Gamer? Can you tell what your question is? Unmute your mic and tell us. Unmute your mic and tell us your question. Can you tell us your question? Okay, I'm not able to unmute your mic. All right, so let me put. Yes. Ashwika Bhargava, can you tell your question? Unmute your mic, please. Unmute your mic and tell us your question. Yes. Please tell us your question. Yes.
Ma'am, my question is, what is the top of the moon?
All right. So, you see, the thing is that if you have just a ball, all right, if you have something which is just a ball, then it would not have any top or bottom or anything. But the moment you have spin on Earth, you have the north and south, and the fact that in solar system, almost everything is in a plane, and almost all motions are in one direction, anti-clockwise direction. So our north-south, with respect to that, we define north-south in our vicinity. And from moon, based on its spin, we are going to define its north and south. We don't say top and bottom, north, south, east, west, etc. And if I talk a little more about liberation, then you have to give me a little time. Maybe some of the questions we will take a little later. All right, Ashwika, I hope your question was answered. So, okay. So, Gamer Dhruv, can you tell your question, please, now?
Ma'am, I was in astronomy club, so they tell me that the distance of the moon, sometimes it increase or decrease. Why it has happened?
All right. Okay, there are two aspects to it. I think somebody else also asked about distance to the moon. And that was, Shlok, I will add you in a while. See, there are two aspects to it. And one of the aspects is going to get related to what we are going to do, which is to do with the liberation. And that is moon, the orbit of the moon around the Earth is not circular, but happens to be elliptical. So because of that, regularly, every month, the distances from the moon to Earth, moon comes in perigee when it is closest to the Earth and apogee when it is furthest away from the Earth. This is a normal change. But over a long period of time, there is a kind of what we call this a little, what is called loss of angular momentum. And in that, moon, when it was initially formed, going around the Earth, it is trying to spiral in and come towards the Earth. And in currently, I mean, the situation is such that moon is actually slowly spiraling out. But that is over a very long time scale, it's going to move further and further away. So we are going to see smaller and smaller. Back very early prehistoric times, we would have seen much larger moon, and slowly it is moving away from the Earth. And let's have one more question here. Shlok Sharma, can you unmute your mic?
Yes, I'll unmute your mic.
Yeah, what is your question, please?
Ma'am, sometimes we see a half moon and sometimes, ma'am, there is no moon.
Yes.
Ma'am, why is that?
Okay, so that is the thing I was going to discuss actually, and we are going to go to our Sky Theater soon to discuss about the phases of the moon. All right, so I think I'll take one last question now with Piyush, who is in the studio, and I request everybody whose questions have been answered to click on the leave studio button, please. Piyush, can you tell us your question, or did you already give your question?
Yes, ma'am, Piyush? I have a question. That ma'am, moon is more close to the sun than the Earth, but then ma'am, why moon has less temperature than Earth?
Moon is not closer to the moon, is closer to the Earth than to the sun. But in any case, the thing is that moon, firstly, doesn't have any atmosphere. So whatever heat comes onto the surface, there is no atmosphere to trap that. And so the moment the sun is not there, Even when the sun is there, it is only going to be one position in the sky. You can actually see the night sky and you can also see the sun in the sky. And so you don't have the kind of heating or pervading heating which goes on. So only the parts where it hits the moon, on the stones, on the rocks, etc. So the energy is transferred. And but because there is no atmosphere, the radiated energy can also go very easily. And so you have a very cold moon. So we may not be able to take any more questions for now, for a while. And because to answer one of the questions about the phases of the moon, and I hope I'll get time to get back to liberation after we discuss the phases of the moon. So I'm going to call in the Sky Theater. I see that the Sky Theater, yeah, it's just come in. And I will request Ashvika, Piyush, and Gavish, if you can please click the leave studio button, because we cannot have too many people in the studio. It allows only 6. So could you please click on the leave studio button? Thank you. All right. So everyone whose questions have been answered, I'm going to go to the Sky Theater now. So we are here at the Planetarium Sky Theater. And so we have actually put a kind of a dummy moon on top of our planetary machine here. And once the lights in the theater are put off and we use a torch light, and we are going to show you the phases. There was a question, right? About why we sometimes see the crescent moon, why we sometimes see the half moon, and so on. So we are going to demonstrate some of these phases. So Sky Theater, are you online? Can we have the demonstration going, please? All right. Meanwhile, while Sky Theater gets ready, I'm going to show using... Yes, yes. We are getting ready in the Sky Theater. So... Yeah. So what is being demonstrated here is phases of the moon using a ball and a torch in a dark room. So you can see that there is a full moon now. And slowly we are going to see, of course, it may not be an exact replica of the phases. All right, I think there is a little bit of a connectivity issue at the Sky Theater. But if you keep looking at what is happening there, you will see that slowly the phases are happening there on that ball. So why are these phases there? All right, I think we seem to have lost connectivity with the Sky Theater. You can do this experiment yourself in a dark room with a white ball. Take a white ball and take a torchlight. And few of you can be there to look at this. And when you hold the torchlight, let's say in this direction, and the sunlight, the torchlight is falling on the ball here, and you stand here. Look at the moon. You should be seeing that the moon is not lit at all. And if you hold the torchlight here, the light is falling here, and you are looking at the moon from this direction, right? So then all the light which is falling here, suppose you are standing here and the torchlight is shining light onto the ball, all the light is coming back to you. So let me add back the Sky Theater and the demonstration will be going on there. You can see that the phases are changing here. Torchlight falling here, all the light coming back. So you have the full moon. If you have a 90 degree angle between the torchlight and the ball, and where you are viewing, you will see half moon maybe in some time in the Sky Theater. We can see the half moon coming. And then if you have a small angle between the torchlight, the ball, and where you are viewing, then you are going to see kind of a gibbous 90 degree. And you have more than 90 degree if you are going in the opposite direction from the torchlight, you will start seeing the crescent. And exactly opposite, you will start seeing the amavas. So just by using a ball and doing this, you can actually demonstrate. You can see how in the Sky Theater you are seeing now crescent moon. And so on. Some of you may have come to the planetarium. We do this. And so these are the phases. Let me actually share screen now. And I have some visuals in this which will help you figure out the phases. Yeah, we had a look at this view earlier. Let's go back to this. And so when the angle between the sun, earth, and moon, it's kind of 180 degree, but sun and moon are in the same kind of part of the sky. All right. So you're going to see crescent, a new moon, crescent, half. And then when the angle increases, you start seeing gibbous. When the angle is 180 degree, but moon on the other side, you see full moon, and then once again as the angle decreases, you will see this. These are the phases that are happening. How they are related to eclipses, we'll see after some time. Let's get back to what I wanted to talk about of the phenomenon of libration. So when libration happens, what do I mean by that, by libration? Let me just see if I have the demonstration here. Yes, so I am going to share my screen, entire screen now with you, and I'm going to show you a small demonstration of libration. All right, so what is happening here? There seems to be some kind of wobble of the moon. It's like you are sometimes seeing little here, little there, little here, little there, and then you're sometimes seeing little here, little there, like that. So that phenomenon is called libration, and because of this, I wonder whether you are able to make out that instead of seeing just one phase, there's a small difference in the phase of the moon that we are seeing. You'll have to look at the corners. Only when you look at the corners, you'll be able to make out the difference. A small difference in this, you'll have to see the edges, all along the edges, and the phases are going to trouble you. That's why I went and had a discussion about the phases also. So you will have to have a little patience and initially to explore this phenomenon of libration, do it virtually. But I want you finally to be able to go out there, look at the moon, and we'll try and give you some information about which are good libration days. And then, so you take a look at this, the crater Grimaldi, for instance. So you can see towards the edge, close to the edge or not close to the edge. Is there a crater behind Grimaldi or not? Look at Mare Crisium. Is it close to the edge or not close to the edge? Is there some feature beyond Crisium or not? And so on. So this is what you will have to do to be able to figure out that there is or there is not any libration. So, where is Sky Theater? Yeah. All right. So, where was I? Yes. Now let's come back to the job that I wanted you to do. And after that, I'm going to go to the questions. All right. It looks like I may have to go for some questions. Otherwise, our studio is going to be... Ahan, did you... You already finished with your question, right? Ahan? Ahan, your question was answered,
ma'am,
right?
Ma'am,
do you have a question now? If not, I'll request that you please click on the Leave Studio button. If you have a question, could you quickly let us know? Ahan?
Ma'am, why does moon have less gravity than Earth?
Yeah, could you repeat? I think we missed the beginning part of your question.
Ma'am, why does moon have less gravity than Earth?
Moon has less mass than Earth. It's about a sixth of the total mass of the Earth. Earth is a much larger body. Moon is a much smaller body, right? That's why. Okay, Ahan, thank you. If you don't mind, could you click on the Leave Studio button? And I'll call in Riddhima now. We'll have to deal with some of the questions before we go on to our discussion of liberation. Riddhima, go ahead, please.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I have a question. How did the moon get craters?
Yes, we had a discussion right in the beginning, right? And we even had a demonstration of crater making, which shows that when a body which is, I mean, small debris body, like when the solar system was initially forming, so there was bacha-kucha, lots of material. And that material may get caught by the gravity of Earth or the moon and plunge onto the surface. And that is what causes the craters. Did you see the crater making? All right. So that was Riddhima, right? So Riddhima, if your question is done, I'll have to request you to click on the Leave Studio button. And Parinita, you can go ahead with your question, please. Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead with
you.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. My question is that if the moon had a hot surface and water reacting it, would the water present there take place?
Actually, Parinita, I'm not able to. It's not very clear. Could you put it on chat, please? We'll try and take your question because it's the audio is not very good. Not able to hear what you're asking. Okay.
Ma'am, is it good now?
No, I'm not able to hear at all. Could you put it on chat, please? Okay, if you don't mind, put it on chat. And if you don't mind, if you click on the Leave Studio, we'll try and answer. quickly put it on chat so I can take a look at it now. And Utkarshini, what is the question that you have? Utkarshini, what is the question? Yes?
Would compass work on moon?
Yeah, okay. That's a very, very nice, very nice question. So compass works on Earth based on its the kind of ordered, structured magnetic field that we have. And we don't, for instance, on the sun, we don't have such a structured one. I mean, we do have, but a very different kind of structure there. And the moon also, it's not as structured. We don't have that island core which we have on Earth and so on. So, but this is a very good question. I think we will take this discussion up later too. So please do stay on, and perhaps we may take it up in the next session, as there are many, many questions now. Okay, but definitely it is not something like Earth. So you won't have the compass working so comfortably. Okay.
Ma'am.
Yes.
We left a bag of garbage on Moon during Apollo 11 mission, and it is clear that Moon surface have got water. So does it mean that microorganisms have grown on the bag?
Okay. So as far as Moon is concerned, though it may have some water, it doesn't have liquid running water. Liquid water is needed generally for life as we know it. We don't have liquid water as such. Whatever water has been found on Moon is in the form of hydrated minerals. Okay. So there is no likelihood that there are microbes or any such thing currently existing on the Moon with the conditions as they are. Okay. Utkarshini, I hope your question was answered. And thank you for asking interesting questions. And if you'll click on those of you whose questions have been answered, you'll click on Leave Studio. It would be good. Ashwika, did you not have your question already? Your question was answered, right? Do you have another question? I want to take... Could you let us know quickly, please, since I have called you? Yes. Yes, please go ahead.
Mom, which is the largest black hole?
We'll deal with in maybe some of the future sessions. Okay, you have a moon related one. Okay, so I think let's leave it for now. We will come to black holes at some stage. We are going to have some further sessions. Today we are dealing with moon, right? So Hrida, Pradeep, please go ahead with your question. I think those who have those questions have been answered, please click on Leave Studio. Hrida, please go ahead with your question.
Okay, ma'am. Does the number of moons have any effect on its planets?
Yeah. Very good question. And the thing is that, we know that our moon, for instance, it plays a role in the tides. What happens is that we have any two masses are going to have their gravitational force on each other. So what happens is that Earth is an extended object. So depending on the position of the moon, the gravitational force that we feel on the different parts of the Earth, because the distance is going to be different. So the force we feel on one side and force we feel on the other side is a little lower. And such differences of gravitational force from the sun as well as from the moon give rise to the tides that we have. And so if there are a lot of more moons, but then it will depend on their mass also. Jupiter has so many moons, but the mass is negligible compared to Jupiter. Whereas Pluto, Charon, for instance, they are comparable. So in such cases, yes, such effects will be there. So now I will request that those whose questions have been answered, please, you click on Leave Studio button. And I need to continue with the discussion. So some of you who are there, please wait a while. So those whose questions have been answered, please leave the studio so that others can come in. And I need to go ahead now with some more discussions. All right. Because we have to have today's discussion has to deal with what we are seeing here. We had a look at how moon is showing us the same phase all through. Why? That was because the rate at which moon is spinning and the rate at which moon is going around the Earth, the two periods are the same. The speed, it is doing it at the same time. It is completing. So that is why we say that we should see one half of the moon. But the orbit of the moon is elliptical. When you have an elliptical orbit, the speed actually varies. So sometimes it's faster and sometimes it is slower. So there is that factor. And the axis of rotation of the moon is tilted with respect to the plane in which it is going around the earth. So these two aspects actually give rise to the fact that when moon is going, I mean, think of this as a moon, that when moon is going around the earth, instead of always showing you the same face, here you see, you are seeing here south. Think of this as the moon, and South America has some feature on the moon. So instead of always showing you only the South America like that, it sometimes may show a little bit more of North America, or a little bit of the South Pole, or a little bit of, if you go, little bit of there. How do I show you the? Yeah. So you may see a little bit of Europe, or more of the ocean. So these phenomenon are called libration. So north south. Somebody was asking top bottom north south of the moon and east west of the moon. Moon has a small wobble. So today session mainly I want you to have some idea about how you can detect this wobble on your own. For that you need to be able to make good friendship with the moon, know the features on the moon. The Maria, we had a small look at that, right? Let me see now. Let us have a small quiz so that, and those of you who know the answer, you can type it at the same time. This quiz is so now. Yes. So somebody knows what this is. This is on the moon. This is a Maria, but which one? Which is this? Which is this? You can put it in chat, the answer to this. And then importantly for our libration observations, I want to know which is this. Does somebody know which this is? We had a discussion earlier. All right, I don't see any chat messages coming in. Has somebody given answer to this? No, I don't see any chat messages coming in yet. So I want somebody to tell me what this is. And also to tell me, near Oceanus Procellarum, you can see this, that little plop of a big crater there, which is this. So this is the quiz I have, that of course you can find out later, and by using all the techniques I'm telling you, you can find out what these features are. But in particular, what is this? This feature, and what is this feature? So yeah, that's a crater, and whereas this one is a Maria. So if you will tell me what those features are, I'm going to give you some help in how you can get to know that moon is actually doing that wobble. To begin with, maybe you'll do it with virtual images, or somebody, some astrophotographer shared some photographs with you. You can take a look at that photograph and say, okay, this libration is happening now in such a way that I'm seeing more of north, or more of south, more of west, or more of east. So that is what I want that you should be able. This is a very, very interesting exercise for you to do. So for that, I want to now show you one resource. This is a NASA resource. I think I will have to share my screen, right? So, my screen was being shared here already. So I have to share my entire screen here, and I'm going to show you. All right, this resource will take some time to come, and I'm going to also type the link for this in the chat. I'll type the link for this in the chat. I hope you can actually see where this is. Let me just quickly type the link for this in the chat so that some of you can explore this. You have to use this in order to make friends with the moon. So I'll just type this in the chat. I hope the link comes. Sometimes the links don't come in chat. Okay, it seems to have gone. So here is the NASA Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter site, and it has taken, by going around the moon, it has taken kind of many images, and a mosaic of those images is what you are seeing here. So this is a very heavy, intensive site. As you can see, it has not loaded fully yet. And you can explore it here. You children are very good at exploring online sites. And there is a way in which you can actually try to find out different craters. So here I have chosen geological features with some overlays, craters, and there is a crater called Pythagoras. So I just want to know which is Pythagoras. Okay, so I will choose the crater Pythagoras. So it is given us the closer view of it. You can see that it is going to take some time, and so the crater Pythagoras. Okay, so the crater Pythagoras is here, and I actually put a blue marker. So if you go out, zoom out, so you can see that this is the moon, and this was all the Oceanus Procellarum region. And so this one, this is Mare Imbrium, and above Mare Imbrium is this crater Pythagoras. So this is something towards the edge. So like this, you will have to figure out some craters and identify these near the edges of the moon. So north, south, east and west, edges of the moon, you try to identify. Take a pair of binoculars, look at the moon, try to identify these features and try to identify these craters. And if you can't do it initially, just go to virtual one like this. Here we have the virtual moon. And also you look up pictures which people are sharing of the moon and try to zoom in and see where is the crater. So this crater Pythagoras, how close to the edge it is. I'll show you something which will give us some idea about the different positions. All right, let me maybe stop sharing screen, and I have that picture with me to put here. So let me just put that picture behind me so that we can try to take a look at how different librations, the different features of the moon. Here we have two pictures of the moon at different librations. When we see a little more of the north or a little less of the north. All right. So in this first view, in the view to the left, we have a little more of the north being seen. Remember I talked about the crater Pythagoras? So I talked about the crater Pythagoras. So the crater Pythagoras here, Pythagoras and the crater Pascal, both are visible. But if you go to the other libration, when you are not seeing so much north, then the crater Pythagoras only is visible, Pascal is hidden behind. And so now here actually Pythagoras and Pascal are visible. Here Pythagoras is visible, but Pascal is gone behind. So this is how you will be able to discern libration. We'll come back to that. As I see that there are many who are trying to enter the studio. So let's deal with some questions now, and then we'll go back to it. So Maya Goel, can you please give us your question?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, let me unmute you. Yeah. Myra, please go ahead with your question.
Ma'am, what will happen if there is no moon?
Yeah, that's a very nice question. We won't see the beautiful moon on the sky. In the sky, the effect of tides of the moon will not happen. Tides, the part of the tides which are due to the moon would not happen, and so on. So essentially that. All right. So we have Venus, for instance, without any moon. Okay, quickly please. Many people are waiting. Yes, go ahead.
What is the speed of the Earth and Moon to rotate and revolve?
Yeah, yet you take a look at the periods that we have. The periods, Earth spins in 24 hours, Moon spins as well as goes around the Earth in about 27.5 days or so. So that will help you do some comparison. I don't remember offhand numbers like that. Can I take some more questions from others, please? And then maybe I'll come back to you if there is time. But if needed, I'll have to give space to others. All right. Ojasvi, please, what is your question?
Ma'am, my question is, ma'am, how the moon revolves around the Earth?
Okay. So why is it doing it also? So we have initially, when the solar system was forming, there was a gigantic cloud of gas and dust, and it had some amount of rotation at that time. And out of that cloud of gas and dust, clumps formed. So the material which formed clumps also had that same rotation. So when initially, maybe if when Earth formed and along with it, maybe moon formed, or there is another picture that perhaps moon, there was one of the idea is that maybe something hit the Earth and a lot of material flew out, and then it was orbiting around the Earth, and then it clumped together to form the moon. So from the initial seed kind of rotation, all of these motions that we see in the solar system are there. All right. So let me add now, Angel Chauhan, can you tell what is your question, please? Are you going to unmute your mic yourself? Yes. Could you quickly unmute your mic and tell us, give us your question? All right. Your mic is muted. So I'm not able to. I'm going to add the next. Yes, Angel, can you unmute your mic and give your question? We are not able to hear you. Okay. Piyush, you can go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. Hydraulics exist that work in moon-like environment, taking into account low pressure and low temperature over there, which is, ma'am, ranging to 143, ma'am, 35 minimum Celsius.
Yeah. So I mean, any of those, we have to keep in mind that we actually practically have like vacuum over there, right? So
yes, ma'am.
You will have to have specialized environment created to be able to use something
hydraulic
of that kind.
Yes.
Right? All right. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
ma'am. Thank you.
So currently, no, you would not. But I mean, given the other locations like Mars, etc., and so on. But wherever you are currently, you have to have create environment which will allow you to stay there, right?
So, yes. Due to low pressure being accounted over there, so ma'am, we have to
practically vacuum-like pressure conditions. Those have to be taken into account. And okay, Parinita, I think you already asked your question, right? Angel was going to ask and then she... Okay, Angel, now can you ask your question, please? Your mic is not getting unmuted. Okay. Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead, please.
Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, please go ahead quickly. And I'll add... Yes, Angel, your mic got muted again, please. We're not able to hear you.
Ma'am, can you hear now?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, my question is that did things get rotten on the moon?
Well, you know, we don't have the bacteria, unless you take some bacteria with you. So, no, and not just the rot kind of a thing, even, you know, like the kind of things which happen on Earth because of its active nature. Like, you know that the footprints of astronauts are still remaining there. There is no air there. And there are no microbes or bacteria, etc., etc. So, and then the temperatures are very cold over there, right? So, I hope that answers your question. Let's get the question from Jomi Jerome.
Good evening, ma'am. My question is, why there is duration of 12 hours between full moon to full moon cycle throughout the year? Why the duration is 12 hours?
I didn't get it. Full moon to full moon is about like you have the 29
cycle
days also, right?
Why the duration is 12? Yeah. So why the duration is 12 hours between a full moon to full moon cycle?
Full moon to full moon cycle is not 12 hours. It is 29 days.
The variation is around... The variation is 12 hours, duration of the full moon to full moon cycle.
Right.
It changes in 12 hours.
You're saying that one full moon, and then when you are going to the next full moon, you are saying that you are adding some time to that. Adding the time to the period of the moon. Actually, no, you are adding some closer to some 2 days or so. Okay, I do have something to show for that. So maybe let me see how many questions are remaining. Let me share my screen and to answer your question, I'll just show a small demonstration. All right. So I hope the screen share is showing up. And so we have the moon going around the Earth 37 point some days. It is doing that, right? So this is, you will say that, okay, from here to here, why is it not full moon? But what happens is that moon going around, this is, let's say moon is going around the Earth. This is Earth is also going around the sun, right, in the same. So moon, when it is completing one cycle around the Earth, it comes back to the position it was in. With respect to, let's say, distant stars, it comes back to this. So this is 27 point something days. all right, the sidereal period of the moon. But when it has done this, by the time it has done this, actually Earth has moved here. So when it has come back here, it is not yet full moon again. Okay, this is actually showing Amavas position, but the same applies, the same logic applies. So you see what happens is that it does this period and it has to do that little extra, which is about 2 days, that little extra before the next full moon comes. So I hope that answers your question. And do you want me to show this once again? And to, for clarity, so Earth is going around the sun. Here is Earth and it moon has done one period. By the time moon does one period, Earth is actually going to move here. All right, Earth is not going to stay here. So this is one period. So one period plus a little more so that it comes back to the same Earth, Sun, Moon situation. So I hope that answers your question. Jomi, okay, I hope that answers your question.
Thank you, ma'am.
So that's that. That was very nice. Thank you for that question. And who else has not had a chance to ask? And Myra, I think you had your question, right? If you don't mind clicking on the Leave Studio for the others to come in. And if you have more questions, you can come in again later. Ipshita, did you have your question asked and answered?
Good evening, ma'am. Ma'am, scientists. Good evening, ma'am. Ma'am, scientists have discovered rocks on moon. So my question is, are there any volcanoes on moon too?
All right. Okay. That's a very good question. There was volcanic activity on the surface of the moon when it initially formed. So a few billion years ago, there was plenty of volcanic activity, but moon has become a kind of a dead object now. There is no such activity. There are no moonquakes or volcanoes or atmospheric erosion or any of those features. All right. But initially there were volcanoes because then that is what, I mean, all this lava flows, it gave rise to these plains. And then on these plains, when the lava flow made it kind of planar, right? And then maybe there were more craters on top of it and so on. So there has been plenty of activity earlier, but not so much now. Okay, Piyush Kumar Sharma, I think your question was also answered, right? So those who are in the studio, if they have questions, they can raise their hands. I may be able to see if your video is on. Ritima, okay. What's your question, please?
Yes, ma'am. And what would happen if moon crashed into Earth?
All right. So, well, it may make a huge, such a huge impact on it, on Earth, and there may be a huge amount of dust, much worse than what happened in the, when dinosaurs became extinct, right? But we don't have that danger. A body like the moon coming and falling on the Earth, we don't have such a danger. So far, we have only some near-Earth objects, and they're not so large, but yeah, sometimes some larger impact may happen. All right, let's take Akshat's question. Akshat, yeah.
Ma'am, my question is that
yes,
does the moon somehow affect on Earth? If yes, then how?
Yeah, moon, we already discussed, right? Moon affects the Earth through its gravitational force. And because Earth is an extended body, so the gravitational force on one end of the Earth and other end of the Earth from the moon being different gives rise to the tides that we see on the Earth, because the pull and also combined with the fact, of course, that Earth is covered with a lot of oceans, and when this difference gravitational pull happens, the land reacts in one way and the water bodies react in another way, and we have this stretching out of water bodies. And okay, so that is what moons cause. Okay, Ashwika Bhargava, can we have your question? You have to unmute your mic. Yes, I hope everyone is taking one question only because we have many people. Yeah, did you already get a chance to ask? In which case, I would like to suggest that you do give time to the others to ask. Yeah.
Ma'am, how
okay,
does
since you are here, go ahead.
Moon get her name?
I'm not able to hear, Ashwika. The sound is not clear. So can you put it in chat?
Ma'am, how does moon get the name?
Well, I don't quite know how the names came about. In general, any satellite objects have been called moons. And then, of course, There are many moons of some objects, so they have special names. But for us, we have just one moon, the planet Earth. All right, I still see that there are many people, but some of them have already had their questions answered. So I have to request them to leave. Click on leave studio button, please. Sviya, can you ask your question? Ashvika, if you don't mind, could you click on leave studio button? If you have further questions, you can put in chat. Sviya, yes, please.
Ma'am, why do we have to wear spacesuit? Ma'am, why?
Because we have to have, why do we have to wear spacesuit, etc., etc.? Because we have to have special conditions that we can live in, right? So only when those conditions are created inside our spacecraft or inside our spacesuit, if we have to go out for a spacewalk and so on, so in on the surface of the moon and so on. So this is very necessary. All right. So, okay. So let's have a couple of questions and then I have to finish my discussion about liberation today. That is the only thing we can complete, I hope. So Shlok, can you go ahead with your question, please? And those whose questions have been answered, I will request them not to be in the studio because those who want to ask questions are not able to come into the studio. Shlok, please go ahead with your question.
Ma'am, I have the question that when, ma'am, like the moon is made of one thing only or, ma'am, many things?
All right, all right. So the earth, for instance, you have the, on the earth, what do you have? You have the land parts, the ocean, and the land, of course, has got all kinds of complicated structure. And you have the core, dense core of the earth, and then you have the mantle, and you have the surface. So the materials which have been found on moon have been found to have composition similar to the mantle layers of the earth. That is why it is thought that perhaps a body impacted on earth and the mantle material flew up and then came together and formed the moon. All right. So I see that still some of you have had your questions answered. You are in the studio. I'll request you to click on leave studio. Now, Myra, did you have a question answered already? If not, you can go ahead.
More question.
Oh, okay. We have to give chance to others. All right. Okay. Go ahead. Now that you are here, go ahead. And yes, after your question is answered, you can click on the leave studio. Go ahead, please.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, why can we see full moon even though the earth is blocking the light?
All right. So we have to talk about the connection between phases and eclipses. So I will do that. In a while, I'm going to talk about the connection between phases and eclipses. All right. Those questions have been answered. Please, you have to click on leave studio. And I think now we may not be able to take any more. So I would suggest nobody else comes into the studio now. And so, all right. So Parinita, did you not get your question answered already? Parinita, did you not have your question answered already?
Ma'am.
Okay. So go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead with your question.
Yes, ma'am.
Go ahead. My question
a moon had a temperature like a hot temperature. So, what would the reactions take place that have the water present there?
Okay, sorry, Parinita, I'm still not able to hear very clearly. Why don't you put it in chat? Then I can read it easily and answer your question. Okay. And
yes,
also,
ma'am.
Did you put it in chat? Put it again now.
Yes, ma'am.
Put it in chat
okay,
so I can
ma'am.
Read it. Okay. Yeah. And please, if you click on leave studio button and Swastika now, please unmute yourself. Let me just see if. Yeah. So, any chat question which comes in now, I will try to take it. And Swastika, please go ahead quickly.
Ma'am, why does the mass decreases when someone is on the moon?
No, sound is not good. Sound is not good. If you don't mind, why don't you put it in chat, please? Your question, I'm not able to hear. Try just once. Say something. No, you muted yourself. Try once whether the sound is better. Okay, I'm not able to unmute you. So Swastika, please go ahead and put it in the chat. Put your question in the chat, please. Yeah. Arav, can you give your question now? Can you tell what your question is?
Ma'am, why does the blue and red moon occur?
All right, blue and red moon. All right, we'll take all of these up. We'll take all of these up when we talk of phases and eclipses. I don't know whether we can do it today, but we will definitely take this question up. Why do we have blue and the red moon and so on? So, all right. I think that's it. Everybody who is in the studio, questions have been answered once. Was it you, Aditya, who talked about this blue and red moon, right? So, I think everybody had at least one question answered. I'm going to stop having people into the studio now for some time. So, there was a question about the phases and the eclipses and so on, right? So, we are going to go ahead and talk about that. And let's see. Okay, we probably are overshooting our time. Let me go to phases and eclipses. Phases, I'll see if I have something with which I can demonstrate right here. The connection between phases and eclipses. That's what I want to talk about. So, all right. So, you can see behind me, you can see the different phases of the moon, right? And now, when the moon is full, the sunlight is coming directly, all the way it's coming to the moon, going back to the earth. So, we have the full moon. But, you would think that earth is actually going to block the light falling on the moon. So, when earth blocks the light falling on the moon, you actually have an eclipse. So, you can have a lunar eclipse. You can see that you will have a lunar eclipse only when it is a full moon. But not every full moon need be a lunar eclipse. Why? Actually, I can demonstrate this very nicely if some of you are here. But the thing is that moon in its orbit around the earth, if this is earth going around the sun, moon is going around the earth in a slightly inclined orbit. So, only when moon comes on these two points, these are called the nodes of the orbit, Rahu, Ketu, only when the moon comes on those two points, the sun, moon, earth and moon can be exactly in a line. Otherwise, it's possible that in that phase relation which I was talking about, you have the torchlight which is falling on the moon and you are seeing the moon from here, let's say. So, you are somewhere here and the torchlight is putting all the light here and it is coming back to you and you have a full moon. But if the torchlight is a little above or a little below the plane between earth and the moon, so you can have the full lit moon, but it will not be eclipsed. So this is what happens. And when you have eclipse, the two come in a straight line and all the light, you say that earth is going to stop falling on the moon, but some light actually goes through the atmosphere of the earth, gets bent, and in that process the blue gets scattered and the red part gets bent and falls on the moon. So less light. And so dim red glow comes. The blue moon is really nothing scientific. It's just that I think if you have two full moons in a month, you get a blue moon. All right. So let me, people in the studio have already at least got to ask one question. So let me see if there is somebody whose question has not been answered at all. All right. So, Jan. Nihar, thanks for being there and giving the answer. Okay. Okay, there is a question, Tanish Jain. Why do we only see one side of the moon and all its phases only on the one side? All right. So, okay. So, now those of you who are in the studio, I will suggest you put your questions now in chat. Because if we are going to have this in the studio, we are going to run out of time. So, any other questions, it will be good to have them just in chat. So, this question which was that why do we see only one side of the moon and all its phases also on one side? The answer to this was given earlier, the fact that it is spinning. Let me just pick up that the presentation I had and show you that picture once again. Yes, that's my presentation. Okay, so here I'll show you this. I hope you are able to see my presentation. And then what happens here, we have the moon. This is the side which we are seeing, let's say. Suppose this is where we are seeing all the Maria that we have named. So, this is now, see, when it comes back to this position, it has finished. If this arrow comes back here, it has done one spin. Where is the arrow now? Arrow has gone downwards. So, when the arrow comes back here, it has done one spin. And when the moon comes back here, it has done one rotation. You see here what is happening? The way the moon is spinning and the way that it is actually rotating is happening almost at the same time. Let's see an alternate picture. Yeah, here, okay, that is the spin of the moon, right? It is done one spin, two spins, and so on. So now, if it was, it is doing one rotation, it has come back to this. So now let's look at this. Suppose we have the spin in such a way, now it is spinning faster. See, it is spinning faster. It is already finished one spin here. And so it is doing another spin now. But it has done only one rotation here. And you can see that sometimes the earth is seeing the arrow, and sometimes it is seeing the arrow tilted, sometimes it is seeing the ultra side from the arrow, and so on. So it is seeing different phases of the moon if the speeds are going to be different. So that is the answer to this question. Okay, so Brijesh Srivastava, you come into the studio, but I think we may not be able to take in any more studio questions. Why don't all of you put every question you have here? And before I leave the studio, I'll try and pick up all the questions, those which have not been answered particularly. And you can see this whole presentation on YouTube, same link that you got. And I'll try and put the answers to it. It will take a little while because it has to come up on YouTube and so on. I'll try to pick up all the questions and answer them. So those who didn't get a chance to come in and ask questions, I want to give priority to them. Those who ask questions should have had actually left the studio and put their other questions in chat. All right, Satya Mitra, you didn't ask any questions till now. Yeah, go ahead.
Have to ask that.
Yes.
What is moon made of?
All right. Okay. So moon presumably is made of the kind of material, as I was saying some time ago, which we have on the mantle of the earth. So material wise, essentially what we have, the kind of rock materials we have in the mantle of the earth, and composition wise, however, the conditions there are different. We don't have the kind of atmospheric gases that we have. So these, any of those which are trapped in rocks, they would not be present. All right. So essentially that is what is the, okay. All right. Yeah, somebody saying, does moon rotate along with revolution? Yes, it does. If moon did not spin, then you would actually see different phases of the moon. And if the moon were to spin very fast and rotate slowly, then also you will see all phases of the moon. But only because the spin and the rotation is about the same, that you see only one side of the moon. However, the main topic today was libration, right? Where you see a little more of the moon. I hope you all got that, and you all are going to try and do the observations. All right. So those of you who are here in the studio, why don't you actually just put your questions? So Brijesh Srivastava, why don't you send a mail to Nehru Planetarium at Gmail? And if there is time, we will try and include. Otherwise, we are going to have continued sessions. So we are actually now, very less time is available now. And all right. So those who are here are already, those who have asked questions already. So I don't want to lose time right now with, yeah. Let me just see if there are any questions. All right, that was a very nice question here. Utkarshini Singh, I hope you did come into the studio. And okay, so that is very good question. Yeah, so the extreme of temperatures are going to give rise to some porosity of material on the surface of the moon. That's very good. Utkarshini, we will try and save this also. Let me just check if there are any other questions. Those who are in the studio, please post your questions on chat. So I will know what are the questions, and then we can try and have discussions. All right. Okay. So how strong is the gravity of moon? So you have about 1/6 of the mass, right, on the moon. So according, all right, let me just see who is. Okay, we seem to be kind of. Brijesh Srivastava, I don't know whether you sent a mail to Nehru Planetarium. Send a mail to Nehru Planetarium, they'll give you the link. All right. No, moon have vegetation? No. And there isn't any kind of life there. So the strength of gravity, why don't you try and see the mass which is there on the moon, take a mass, maybe some test mass or something, all right, and you try and calculate the gravitational force. You know that you are using the gravitational constant g, and then m1, m2, and you have to have the distance. Use the same distance for moon and for Mars, for Earth, and just use this difference in mass, which is 1/6 for moon, and try to figure out. And in fact, you will try. You can even get your weight on moon from that calculation. All right. And nehruplanetarium@gmail. You have to send to nehruplanetarium@gmail. I have a fresh entrant. No, Parinita, you already had your question once asked. So if you just put your fresh questions on chat, I'll just check, and then we will see which are questions are to be discussed. Okay, that was a very good question here. What decides how many moons will a planet have? So the thing is that depends on what was the original material which was forming this. As I said, when solar system is forming, I have to figure out, so many things are coming, I'm not able to do the hide to this. Sorry about that. All right. Okay. So the thing is that the material which is there, if you have larger material, like when Jupiter formed, there was a huge clump, and the leftover material was also quite a bit, and many moons formed. So when the giants formed, there were many moons which formed. And but of course, in the terrestrial planet, Mercury doesn't have, Venus doesn't have. So perhaps being closer to the Sun may also have had a role to play in it. Earth has one, Mars has two, and so on. So essentially the initial material which is there. All right, that was one question. Why does the mass decrease? Yeah, we have just this larger clump Earth formed and a smaller clump formed, which was the water on moon. Somebody wants to talk about that water on moon. Yes, water on moon, the Chandrayaan missions had a lot of role to play in it. However, it is not water, running water. What has been, there was a NASA payload, moon mineralogy mapper on Chandrayaan 1, and I will try and show some of the results from that, maybe towards the end. So, okay, has any space mission landed on the far side of the moon? Yes, there has been. Recently, there was a Chinese mission which landed on the far side of the moon. Okay, so see, those who are in the studio, please put your question in chat so I will know. Okay, so this question is, the weight is lighter because your mass g, m1, m2, and you have the r, and so if the r is the same and m2 is the same, but m1, so this is how you will measure gravitational force, right? So g, m1, m2, and then you have r square in the denominator. So m2 and r are the same. M1 larger for Earth and m1 smaller for moon, so that is how you will have much less weight. Okay, what is the weather? There is no weather, essentially. There was a question about what is the weather on the moon. There is no weather at all. Yeah, okay. So this is a useful question. Why do we see the moon in different colors like yellow and red? See, the light that is coming from the moon, it is essentially what is getting reflected from the sun. All right. So essentially what you have coming from there, entire light that is reflected, so you would see the color of the moon is based on that light that we have. And then when the moon is just rising or it is just setting, what happens is that the radiation is coming through the atmosphere. And at that time, we have once again the radiation that is coming through the large path in the atmosphere. And so the blue part, a little bit gets scattered out, and it is the reddishness that we see. And so we have that yellowish or slightly orangish glow of the rising moon. And we have that glow on a lunar eclipse, I explained earlier, because through the atmosphere of the Earth, radiation goes and falls on the moon. And again, the reddish part is falling. And so that is what we have. And so Parinita, Piyush, Vidhi, I think, did you get a chance to ask a question earlier? So why don't you post it in the chat here? Then I can pick up the question from there. Yeah, Nihar, thanks for that clarification. Mass will not change. What will change is the gravitational force that you feel. So your weight. the weight that you will be is going to change. The question which there is a question here: when Apollo left the moon and its part fell down, why was there a ringing sound for 1 hour? Now, what is this? This is something I myself am unaware of, but there may have been, I mean, some electronic noise in the communication which was being picked up. So, okay, maybe let's take this up a little later. Let me take a look at that too. All right. Other moons. Yeah, all right. There's a question here. I think it is best now that we just do the questions through chat. So I would suggest Paranita, Piyush, Vidhi, you can put all your questions by chat, because then we'll move faster. So Shivanshu's question is, are the moons of different planets different or same? So the thing is that, once again, all the material which was forming in the solar system, initially it may have had been the same. But each of these objects had a kind of a differentiation. This is that the smaller bodies lost a lot of what are called volatile materials. The larger bodies kept the volatile materials. So small differences in compositions would have had come about from that. So from those different initial conditions, you may get slightly different compositions, etc., of material which is there, formed at different locations. So you will definitely get differences in individually. They are not going to be carbon copies. All right. So, all right. Let me see which are the other questions. So, there are a lot of questions. I'm very happy. And I'm sorry, those of you who are... okay, Vidhi. All right. Vidhi's question. Vidhi's... All right. So, Vidhi, that was your question? That there will be a day when there will be no moon. Well, as of... I mean, the thing is, current conditions, moon is slowly moving far further away. So, we may see smaller, but over a long period of time. Maybe if there is a huge impact of some kind and it disturbs the moon, but we don't see any data which is going to telling us that such a thing is there. So no, you go to Venus, go to Mercury, you will not see the moon. Okay, so I do not know how, Brijesh, then put your question please. All right, just put your question on chat. Right now, I think that is what we will do. Okay, the question about why is it red, I already answered. All right, what are the other questions? Let me just check. I think... all right. How was the Earth formed? What is inside the moon? Okay, these are good questions. What is inside the moon? And how was Earth formed? Earth essentially formed, in all these discussions that we are doing, it was initially material which was kind of a gigantic gas cloud, dust and gas, and it collapsed under its own gravity. Different clumps formed. Sun formed the major body was the sun, and the different clumps are the planets which formed. All right. So, okay, I do see that there are many questions, so some of these probably we'll have to take up now. Brijesh Srivastava, why don't you just put your question in chat? And there are some experts also who are answering in the chat. Nihar, thanks for answering. And if you want to come into the studio, please, you are welcome. Do that too. Okay. So what is this question? Earth has two moons? No. I think this has been some kind of nonsensical news which is going on. Earth, no, it doesn't have, it has, it's one moon, it has several artificial satellites. Sometimes people have been saying, oh, you will see Mars as bright as moon and so on. Maybe it is that fake news. There are several such. Okay, so, okay, what decides how many craters a moon should have? We don't have any such decision made. Craters keep happening whenever there is material, leftover material, which is falling on the moon. And it is making craters. And on the moon, you have a large number of craters because you don't have an active surface of the moon. No volcanoes, no earthquakes, no atmosphere and so on. So you have a much larger number of craters there. All right. So though somebody wants to go to NASA, go to ISRO also, all the very best. For that, all of you, I hope, can express your interest in astronomy in various ways. All right. So is there any other question? I think we'll have to now wrap up soon. So creatures, there is a question about creatures. No, only the only creatures are the dozen people who walked on the moon, the dozen astronauts who walked on the moon at some time. But no, the conditions are not. All right. I do not quite know exactly the ringing sound that you are referring to, but yes, sometimes there have been attempts to kind of impact on the moon and try to observe the material which is coming out, and this ringing sound perhaps is from the communication. Otherwise, you will not actually hear anything coming from there. So there have been impacts on the moon. Yes. Avika, why don't you put your question in chat? Parinita already put it. So Avika, why don't you put your question in chat? All right. Let me just look up chat questions. And I want to wrap up with our discussion about liberation, right? Okay. So yeah, this probably we'll have to take it up a little bit about this later in our subsequent discussions. All right. So, let me just check. All right. So, I think a lot of the questions are repeat. So, I will not. All right. But if some are left, I will definitely go through all the chat. If any questions are left, we will try and answer them in chat. All right. This, maybe we just put this as the last one. So, duration of night and day in the moon. So, this is going to come about. There are going to be some amount of complexities. But essentially, when moon is spinning, so the side that we are seeing, and the side that we do not see, both sides actually see the sun over the period of the spin of the moon. So, that happens around the 27 and a half days. So, that will be the duration for night and day. On the moon, there will be some complexities, but that will be the duration. All right. So, when there is no moon, now there is this question. Yeah, what is inside the moon? I said that I'll defer that. Dust. Yes, there was a question earlier about the extreme temperature variations and porosity of possible surface material. So, that will be there, definitely, on the surface of the moon. But it will not fly up because there is no atmosphere over there. And so I think probably that. So Avika and Parinita, I hope you put your questions on chat. I see that you're still in the. Okay, Brijesh Srivastava, why does? Let me answer Brijesh. Then I come to Nihar is pointing out something. Weight does get lighter, Brijesh. That is the thing, because you have less mass there, and Nihar is actually trying to clarify that when people are talking of second moon, recently there was a news which talked about that as something which is orbiting the Earth, some of the near Earth. But as Nihar is clarifying, this is occasionally crossing Earth's orbit. So, yeah, there was recently a news item about that. But this is again one of the minor bodies. This is actually an asteroid. So, but because of its orbital period, a specific connection with Earth, Moon, position and distance perhaps, I don't know. So maybe we'll just look at this in the subsequent. Or Nihar, maybe you could post further clarification. All right. So, yeah. Let me just see. All right. I see that's it. Krish Joshi is one new internet, I think. Did you get a chance to ask any question earlier, Krish? So you can go ahead. I think after this we have to wrap up. I'm not able to unmute you, Krish. So you can post your question in chat, and I think we will have to now wrap up here. Yeah, we have to. I just want to get back to the original point which I wanted to make to all of you. So many of you have got interested in the moon now, right? So try and make friends with the moon. Try to find out what are all these different features right, to figure out what are the features towards the edges. And for that, you will have to use that the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. I'll try to put the link in the final chat on YouTube so that you can go and explore that. Try to figure out what are all the craters which are here. There's a list of moon craters, and try to find out which are the craters which are on the extreme edges. So the tables actually will give you latitudes and longitudes. So try to figure out on the extreme edges of the moon and try to observe them. Using a pair of binoculars would be sufficient for you to observe the crater Grimaldi, let's say Mare Crisium, even naked eye you can see it. But you have to see the distance to the edge. And remember how we were sketching it in the beginning? Our planetarium artist was sketching it for you. So if you don't have astrophotography possibility right now, just look at the moon with a pair of binoculars, make this sketch, and you will be able to have a bit of an idea about libration, which is taking place. All right. So I think we will have to wrap up here. All right. So I see that Ojaswi Darwal, I don't know if you had a chance to ask a question. Maybe we'll just end with this. What is your question? Did you ask a question
Ma'am,
earlier? If not,
the
go ahead.
Moon
yeah.
Pond first or the Earth?
Ah, all right. Most probably Moon later. Because the okay, that was a nice question to end with. She wanted to know whether Moon formed first or Earth. The current accepted theories of formation of the Moon are saying that perhaps some body, Earth was already there. Some object came and impacted on Earth. Material flew out and then Moon was formed. So, a little later. So, I think this is time for us to wrap up here. And yeah. So, I think we are going to stop the broadcast. I see that there are some more people here in the studio, but who already did get to ask their questions. So, I think we probably may not have chance. So, I'm just adding whoever was here. But there won't be chance right now, because you could have had put your questions in chat.
Ma'am,
right?
I have put my question in the chat box.
Yeah, but I thought I answered some of them. Okay, so those of you who are in the studio now, go ahead one by one. Avika Sharma,
Ma'am,
what is Udran your question?
Sharma. Ma'am, I'm Udran Sharma. Ma'am, I have question that why does the moon have less gravity?
So this has already been discussed, right? It has less mass, right? And so this is a Krishi Joshi. What is your question? Krish Joshi and Ashvika Bhargava.
Yes, ma'am.
And I think, yeah. So what is your question? Was it not answered? What was the question?
Ma'am, I have put it my question in the chat box.
Why don't you now tell me what it is? Because the chat box has so many things. No, I'm not able to see. So what is the question now? Tell me.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, my question was that is there any possibility that we are going to find any of the creatures on Moon after a very long time at all?
There are no creatures. No, the conditions seem to be that there cannot be any creatures. All right. So, if there are there any fresh new questions or unanswered questions from chat? Anybody
Ma'am,
wants to ask
I am putting my question one more time.
I'm not able to hear. Ashvika, this we have not been able to hear, right? There's a lot of
Ma'am,
disturbance.
Ma'am, I am putting my question one more time.
What is the question? Why don't you say it?
Ma'am, it is so long question I have.
What? So why don't you say, okay, there is a very good question here from Vishnu Swain. Largest Maria, probably it is Oceanus Procellarum is what is the largest one. And the far side of the moon, which we don't see, doesn't have so many maria. Maybe we'll take that up next time. I didn't hear any questions from the students who are in the studio. So shall we now make it call it a day? Those who are in the studio did not give me any questions which I could hear.
Ma'am, I have put it my question.
No, don't tell me chat, Anna. Please just repeat it now. Tell me the question.
Ma'am?
I don't hear any question.
Ma'am, I cannot hear you.
All right. So, okay, you put your questions in chat and I'll try to answer them later in chat. We are going to, I think Swastika Rao, you did not come in earlier. Go ahead.
Ma'am,
Ma'am, which is the smallest and largest known moon in the whole universe?
Oh, that's a very good question. Let's end with this. You want to know which is the smallest and the largest known moon in the whole universe? I don't really have an answer to that, but that's a very nice question. So we'll pick that up and try to find an answer to that in our next session. All right. Swastika, can you also put it in chat so that I can flash it into the session? And we will find the answer to that in the next session. All right. So now, bye, everybody. Thank you for being there. It was very nice to have such an active session. And maybe some of your answers could not be taken up. Some of you could come into the studio. Some of you could not. So we'll have to figure out how to see that all the relevant questions come in, so where everybody will benefit. And it may be perhaps easier if we just have the questions as chat instead of coming into the studio. Maybe we will do that from the next time onwards. Just use the questions in chat. That would be sufficient. And so there was, why there is no ice on moon? Okay. Well, there is no liquid water directly on the moon. There is no water as water present on the moon. There's only hydrated minerals on the moon. So that is the reason why we don't have that. And All right. So, okay. So, yeah. So this is, so I think with this question, we are going to end the session today. I hope all of you enjoyed. You can give further comments after the broadcast too. I think you can give some comments and any feedback and what is it that you want in our next sessions and so on. So with that, I thank all of you and I hope you all enjoyed it. So bye then.